Over the past months, amendments of constitutional and electoral reforms have raised dust from a section of Ugandans.
Constitutional body cannot cede its authority to another body or organ. So there is no way you can say that the Electoral Commission has surrendered its role of updating, compiling a register to the Immigration Department or the Minister of Foreign Affairs. And that is part of the message we are sending to the country.
And this force, and I hope our parliament will take this matter as seriously as it can, to launch an inquiry into the Uganda police force and its partisanship. You know, to display campaign posters of a political party and a candidate in the offices of the police, which is supposed to provide security for elections, is a matter of very, very grave.
We are going to distribute these materials widely. We have come up with the literature on sensitization of the public, the masses, on the kind of situation we are grappling with.
These and more reactions have put government in a tight spot as pressure of the amendment mounts on a daily basis.
Don't lift me. I'm going to walk myself. Please, don't. Just let me walk freely.
With only a few months left to the general elections scheduled for February 2016, one wonders if these electoral reforms are achievable.
Like, for example, Center for Constitutional Governance proposed that the head of Electoral Commission should be at the level of Supreme Court judge. So do we have time then for soul searching? Then is there time to enact the relevant laws that will see these electoral reforms implemented? For example, majority people want commissioners of Electoral Commission to be appointed through the Judicial Service Commission. This mandate does not exist in the act that establishes the Judicial Service Commission. It's a new mandate. So you need to go back and give this mandate to the Judicial Service Commission.
If amended, this will be one of its kind in years, unlike the Dochi Commission of 1995 and Professor Sempewa of 2005 that had more than 1 year to collect citizens' views in the amendment of the constitutions.
This is a unique way that we have sought to amend the constitution, but it's also provided for under Article 260 of the constitution. So Parliament must stand up to the challenge, get people's views.
It's against this background that Sabiret expresses fear that Uganda is likely to experience constitutional regimes of 1962 and 1967 respectively.
And that's why I'm calling upon Parliament to use known shared principles and practice of constitutional amendment. There are no party positions. It is not a Chankwan's position about the constitution. It is about the people's views.
The task is now upon Parliament to make constitutional and electoral reform proposals a reality, as demanded for by Ugandans ahead of the 2016 general elections.